Tesla has updated its Cybertruck production timelines for different versions of the electric pickup truck after strong pre-orders for the highest performance versions. The Tesla Cybertruck was unveiled last month, and with it three different versions: the single motor rear-wheel drive, the dual motor all-wheel drive, and the tri-motor all-wheel drive. When Tesla CEO Elon Musk shared the Cybertruck, at the time he said that the two less expensive versions with single or dual motors and small battery pack are coming in late 2021, while the more expensive version with more motors and bigger battery pack is going to be available in late 2022. When giving the first pre-order count, Elon Musk said that 42% of reservation holders chose the dual motor option, 41% chose the tri-motor option, and only 17% chose the least expensive single motor option. It would seem the pre-order percentages haven't been kind to the entry-level single motor Tesla Cybertruck. Days after the reveal, Musk tweeted the company had received 250,000 pre-orders, which likely persuaded Tesla to revamp the truck's production schedule to build the more in-demand trims first. It doesn't hurt the dual and tri-motor trucks, both all-wheel drive, are $10,000 and $30,000 more respectively than the entry-level single-motor truck that starts at $39,900. Following strong pre-orders of the Cybertruck, Tesla's changed its production timeline for the high-performance versions. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss Tesla's Cybertruck, which updates production timeline after strong pre-orders. Why Tesla Cybertruck's more powerful versions get production priority. Why Elon Musk gets governor's welcome to build Tesla Cybertruck in Alaska. Let's get into details. According to the pre-order page of Tesla Cybertruck, production on the dual-motor all-wheel drive and tri-motor all-wheel drive models is slated to begin in late 2021. This, of course, is in line with the production guidelines Tesla announced at the pickup truck's unveiling. Production of the single-motor, rear-wheel drive Tesla Cybertruck model, however, has been pushed back by a full year. Per Tesla's updated website, production for the $39,900 model won't begin until late 2022. The reality, it seems, is that anyone interested in the base model Tesla Cybertruck will likely have to wait until 2023. Releasing higher-end, more expensive versions of its vehicles is a strategy that Tesla's been using on and off. When Tesla started manufacturing the Model 3, it made a point to prioritize production of pricier configurations. As a result, folks interested in purchasing the entry-level Model 3 for $35,000 were forced to wait for quite some time. The rationale behind Tesla's decision in this regard was quite simple: to generate as much cash as possible, as quickly as possible. At the time, Elon Musk said that if Tesla started shipping the low-cost Model 3 right away, it would cause Tesla to lose money and die. While Tesla's economic situation isn't as precarious as it once was, the company is capable of turning a profit these days, it's employing the same production strategy it used with the Model 3 on the recently introduced Cybertruck. Put simply, Tesla will focus on producing the dual-motor and tri-motor all-wheel drive models before turning its attention to the entry-level single-motor rear-wheel drive model. While this may be frustrating to many prospective buyers, it does make sense from a business perspective. Demand for Tesla vehicles has never been much of an issue, but the company's penchant for bleeding money certainly has. Consequently, it makes sense why Tesla would want to focus on more profitable Cybertruck models above all else. It will be easier for Tesla to produce the truck profitably if it starts at $50,000 than if it starts at $40,000. It's worth mentioning that Tesla has something of a bad history when it comes to meeting production deadlines. Indeed, every car Tesla's ever released has been subject to long delays. Looking ahead, with the Tesla Semi, Tesla Roadster 2, Model Y, and Cybertruck in the pipeline, it'll be interesting to see if the delays continue, or if Tesla can actually meet its initial production projections across the board. As Tesla's had trouble meeting deadlines in the past, but we're still 2 years away from Cybertruck production beginning, and a lot can happen between now and then. There are questions about the legality of the truck's design and how it would conform to federal motor vehicle safety standards. And answering those questions with a design revamp could delay the truck. As a final note, Morgan Stanley analyst Adam Jones recently told that Tesla, in a best-case scenario, could sell upwards of 100,000 Cybertrucks by the end of 2024. The pickup truck market is undeniably huge, but it remains to be seen if the unique aesthetic of the Cybertruck actually helps lure buyers in or pushes them away. With the Cybertruck, Tesla has integrated several of its technologies into one offering. The truck features the same stainless steel alloy being used at Musk's other company, SpaceX. And it has lithium-ion batteries, software and hardware for self-driving and solar roof option to help boost the Cybertruck's range. The stainless steel exterior, sharp, science fiction-inspired design, and ludicrous performance promised in the tri-motor offering are stunning. It can tow up to 14,000 pounds, offer 500 miles of range, and sprint to 60 miles per hour in 2.9 seconds. We can see why people would overlook the single-motor truck. The efficiency of most gasoline engines is between 17 and 21%. For electrical vehicles, the conversion of electrical energy into power to drive the wheels is 59 to 62%. This gives electric vehicles a clear performance advantage. The cost of operating electric vehicles, including fuel and maintenance, ranges between 65 to 77% less across US and Canada than it costs to drive and maintain gasoline-fueled vehicles. Due to its weight and size, Tesla Cybertruck is likely to be somewhat less efficient than the electric passenger cars currently available. However, when compared to other non-electric trucks, the inherent efficiency advantage of electric motors and the aerodynamics of the Tesla Cybertruck are substantially better. Tesla has two main advantages that will likely make the Cybertruck a winner. First, Tesla has an advanced and extensive charging network that allows the owners of its products to quickly refuel. There are currently more than 14,000 superchargers worldwide. Second, Tesla has invested heavily in battery technology and manufacturing. Its gigafactories are expanding and using more renewable energy, including solar power, to reduce the ecological footprint of batteries. As a result, Tesla is able to scale up production and will probably be able to keep the cost of its vehicles lower than competitors. Tesla's Cybertruck and the growing number of offerings by other manufacturers of electric vehicles likely represent the beginning of a larger transition away from internal combustion engines. The Tesla Cybertruck may be polarizing, but it's a vehicle that's captured the interest of the motoring world and beyond. And while neither Tesla nor Elon Musk has announced any details about where the upcoming all-electric pickup truck would be produced, this has not deterred a government official from extending an offer to the CEO. In a recent tweet, Alaska Governor Mike Dunleavy invited Elon Musk to consider utilizing the state's resources to build the electric car maker's premium vehicles. The governor specifically mentioned the company's recently unveiled Cybertruck in his offer, stating that Alaska stands above other areas when it comes to balancing resource development. Hey Elon Musk and Tesla, let's talk about utilizing Alaska's vast resources to help build Tesla cars and the new Cybertruck. Nobody in the world balances resource development and environmental stewardship better than us, he wrote. Dunleavy's invitation is quite notable considering that the governor has reportedly maintained a controversial stance on climate action, a topic that Tesla CEO Elon Musk is very particular about. Over his tenure as Alaska's governor, critics have argued that Dunleavy's administration has done very little to combat climate change, as shown when he disbanded the state's Climate Response Task Force just months after assuming office. Neither Tesla nor Elon Musk has posted a response to the governor's open invitation so far. Love it or hate it, Tesla Cybertruck is a game changer. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.